Hey guys, Timmy here, and if you've been on my channel for a while or you look at my most viewed videos, you'd see I've done two videos on the topic of gaming PCs versus the next gen consoles. Now the next gen consoles have been out for roughly about a year, 9 months or so, a good amount of time for people to get them, a lot of people to get them, a lot of games to come out for them, and a lot of people seem really disappointed with them. Some people really like them, and that's fine, but some people they seem underwhelmed. They really expected more from them. Now, I mean, I'm not gonna say that, oh, they're just absolutely terrible. I mean, they're reasonably well-made machines and reasonably well-made game consoles, and they play their games well, and a lot of people like them. A lot of people, they play their games and they enjoy them, and that's great. But some people, they're underwhelmed. They tried Watch Dogs, for example. They bought Watch Dogs on their Xbox One, and they're just saddened, not saddened, but they're confused on why the resolution like that was released for it, and the FPS was only capped at 30 FPS, how that happened. And many people were confused by that. They were just, they didn't like that, and it does kind of sadden you. And it's really kind of sad when you buy a new console expecting, hey, this is an upgrade for my Xbox 360, my PS3, and you get a new console and it's good, it is definitely an upgrade, but it's not as much of an upgrade, and it seems like not really much has changed, and you feel like you're getting gouged more and more for things that you don't want. And that's why some people, they'll bring it up, the whole gaming PC argument and how you should build a gaming PC. And I, for one, I agree with that. I personally do not think the next gen consoles are worth it right now. There's really not much exclusive wise to bring out and really get a console for. I mean, yes, there is, what is it, Xbox One, I know Rise and Dead Rising 3, the Xbox One exclusives are coming to PC, and it really leaves, what, Halo and Forza left, and maybe some other indie games that's left on the Xbox One. The PS4 has Infamous, Killzone, and Last of Us Remastered, and the whole remastered argument, I'm gonna just put that aside for another video, because I think it's starting to get ridiculous now. But there's not really a lot of games that people want to play, and many people are resorting back to playing either older consoles for older games. Hell, GTA 5 is still a hugely popular game, and that's on the last gen of consoles. And many people are like playing the last gen and still keeping their consoles for those games, or they're just playing like the games that they would normally play and that are still being released on the last gen consoles. For example, Call of Duty, FIFA, Madden, so on. And that's the whole thing. And many people, and for example, a lot of like people that really like gaming suggest getting a gaming PC. And there's obviously the pros and cons to each. I mean, people say you can't really split screen with a game PC. You can. It's really not as much. Game PCs are more gaming. That's the thing. And many people were like, you can't, I like to sit on, I don't want to sit at a desk. I want to slouch over on my keyboard on playing the game. Like, I don't feel comfortable doing that. That's fine. Because if you have any HDTV that you use to play your next-gen console or whatever, if you have any HDTV built in the last couple of years, it most likely has an HDMI port in it. All you have to do, if you have a gaming PC, all you do is plug in the HDMI from, say, your graphics card to your TV. You get a controller, an Xbox 360 controller is more than enough. You could even get, like, a wireless PC, keyboard and mouse. There's, like, a touchpad kind of thing. It's, I don't know, if you want to get one, look it up, I don't know. Use that and plug it in, and there you go. You can sit on your couch playing your games on your TV from your PC, and you still have that great experience. Now, maybe we're like, it's more expensive. Yes, I'm not gonna lie, it is more expensive. People say, oh, build a $400, $500 gaming PC. It's possible, it will work, it just won't be worth it. You'll have performance that is good, and it's on par or a little bit better than the next gen consoles, but you're really sacrificing yourself there. And one big thing is, you don't have to pay for online. That's one thing that still surprises me about how Microsoft and Sony do this. I understand they have to keep up an infrastructure, and they have to have security on like the whole Xbox Live and PSN, but you don't have to pay for that on PC. Steam is completely free, which is great. Origin, Uplay, all those other services. Even you can get, you don't even have to use like say Steam, for example. You could use other websites where you could just buy it and download it there, no DRM. You don't have to pay for that. That's all free. I mean, yes, you're paying for the game, but you're not paying for the online. The online is you're already paying for that with your ISP. You don't have to pay another charge that Microsoft or Sony are charging to you. So that's a great thing. And say you have your Xbox One for 5-6 years, that's $300-$360 of just online, of just years. I believe it's $60 a month. Of like right around there, you're paying that much in just connecting to the service, which I think is ridiculous. And you could put that more towards a gaming PC. You could put that more towards a lot of other things. And let's say you have, maybe we're like, it's again with the gaming PC argument, you're gonna go out and buy, say, a laptop that you're gonna use for just normal work or checking email, Facebook, so on. Or even get like a desktop, you could, you know, use that or whatever and buy that every couple of years because it gets slow, but you still have your next gen console. So let's say you buy, you need a desktop for your home, you buy a, I don't know, Best Buy desktop, it's about $550, right around there, and a next gen console for $400, that's around $950, right around there. You can build a beastly gaming PC that is very good, that will max out any game right now. Build that and easily play any game you want and still have the functionality of a PC and really have all the things that you need. It could play games, then you could alt tab and check your email, post to Facebook, and then go back to playing your games. There's no need to go to your couch and then turn on your laptop and then go and grab your controller for your next gen console. It's very seamless. It's all built into one, which is really, really great. And that's just really it, man. I mean, I'm not saying do not have a next gen console. It's absolutely worthless. I'm just saying open up your mind to other ideas. There are better alternatives. And if it's really just not for you, if the exclusives really matter to you, if all that really does matter to you, go ahead. Go to the Best Buy, go to any store, buy your next gen console, buy your PS4, buy your Xbox One. Enjoy it, play it, play for the games, man. That's all that matters. Just be a good man about it. Just the games are all that matter, and that's really it. So I hope you enjoy. Tell me what your opinion is on the whole gaming PC, Xbox One, next gen console, PS4 kind of thing. Just leave that all in the comments. I want to know what you think about it. And yeah, maybe one day if I get a lot of subscribers and maybe build up a good fund towards it, I'll do like a guide on making a powerful, reasonably priced gaming PC that will rival the next gen consoles, and maybe I'll build that and maybe actually make it in a video, because that'll be pretty cool. I've seen other YouTubers do it, but it'd be pretty cool if we did it. So yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed, like, favorite, subscribe, all that stuff, and I'll see you guys next time.